me now, Republican Senator John Cornyn from Texas. And Senator, good afternoon to you. What's the holdup here?
Well, it appears to be that our Democratic colleagues see this as a moving vehicle to spend a lot of money on their ideological wish list, everything from global warming to the union representation in private businesses on their boards of directors to tax credits for solar and wind energy. None of that is what we ought to be working on now. We can deal with those fights later on. What we ought to be working on now is getting money to the people who are not getting a paycheck and making sure that they have a job to go back to after this crisis passes.
Senator, take the Democratic argument out of it. If you pass it in your form, what would be the effect on the moment, on the American situation?
Well, right now we see all the money that people have seen accumulated in their 401k or their retirement savings go down the tube because the markets are uncertain that the Congress is up to the task, can do this job. The president has, I think, led well. This is an unprecedented crisis. Nobody has encountered anything like this before, but it requires some cooperation and really putting our patriotism and our common American citizenship before we put our partisan political or ideological agendas. That's what's holding it up.
What then do you believe is the outcome of the month? There's so many unknowns of this, Senator. I mean, it's not entirely guesswork, but it's close to it. If you don't do it now and you get further delay, what is your expectation for the situation then?
Well, I think that now that the objections that are coming to the forefront are not about getting money to people who need it or making sure they have jobs to go back to, but more about this ideological wish list or outbox that they're trying to use this as leverage for. I think the Democrats will come to the table. Senator Schumer needs some sort of face-saving device. That's why he's talking about continuing to have negotiations with Secretary Mnuchin. But they know in their heart of hearts that we have to get this done for the American people because our economy, which is the envy of the world, is going down the tubes unless we can rise to this moment.
Senator, Secretary Mnuchin said yesterday the Federal Reserve will provide up to $4 trillion in liquidity. Think about that, $4 trillion. My question to you is, as you look at this, is as absurd as this may sound, is that enough?
Well, I don't think we know, and I think what we're trying to do is send a message that this is shock and awe. We want to reassure investors, we want to ensure the job creators that we are serious about doing our part. But unfortunately, this partisan gamesmanship, I think, undermines that confidence. But yeah, we'll get through this. Our healthcare providers are the best in the world. Our scientists are the best in the world. We'll find a way to defeat the virus. But we've got to make sure that people have jobs. We've got to make sure that people have paycheck coming in because they don't have work.
Senator, will it get done by tonight? Yes or no?
I would love to hope so, but I can't tell you with any confidence. I think it will get done in the next 48 hours.
John Cornyn from Texas, thank you, sir.
Thank you.